This is Burke. It's been around for 7 generations, but all the buildings are new. That's because Burke has a bit of a pest problem. Or more accurately, a bit of a dragon problem. And Vikings are a bit too proud and a bit too stubborn to change their ways. They pride themselves by their ability to slay dragons. Now this includes every living member of this community. Every single person, except Hiccup. A scrawny, wimpy excuse of a Viking whose main specialty is to get in everyone's way. But Hiccup wants to change. He wants to prove himself and make his father proud, who just so happens to be the chief. To prove himself, Hiccup sets his sights on the legendary Night Fury, a dragon that nobody has ever been able to take down. That is, until Hiccup. Nobody believes him, and so the next day he travels out to return proof of his kill. But he didn't kill the dragon, and when Hiccup tries to finish the job, he can't. He won't. He cuts the dragon free, and it decides to spare his life in return before attempting to fly away, but it can't escape due to an injury. He realizes that everything they know about dragons is wrong. But now, with a newfound desire to learn more about these creatures, his dad decides that it's finally time for him to learn how to kill dragons. How to Train Your Dragon is absolutely terrific. The script is airtight. The movie trails along at a very fast and very even pace. Just about every spoken line is simultaneously humorous and informative. This is a snappy, fun movie. This is a movie that does every little thing right. There isn't a bad scene or a wasted moment, it's just perfect. How to Train Your Dragon is a pretty straightforward story, one with themes and messages that you've seen 100 times before. And the movie is pretty predictable. It's an animated family movie, they're not trying to pull a fast one on you. But what makes this movie so special, and what really makes it stand out, is that it focuses so strongly on the emotional angle. This is a movie purely about strained character relationships. Hiccup is a pariah. Nobody in the village respects him. His father is embarrassed of him. And yeah, even the dragon doesn't like him so much. But as Hiccup starts to gain trust with Toothless, the dragon, and their relationship starts to build with mutual respect and trust, and they start helping each other out, and it'll just melt your heart. These first interactions are when you realize this movie is something very special. Toothless is completely lovable. He's basically a giant cat. Although, he's literally a dragon. It's also during these moments that you realize that a massive piece of this movie's charm is its explosively brilliant musical score. The music is exciting, it's magical, and it's just beautiful. There are moments in this movie that I tear up at every time I watch it, and I'm starting to get suspicious that it's largely because of the emotional music. But the movie obviously has heart, and it's such a heartwarming and kind story, so it's like a 1-2 combo and I'm blubbering like a baby. As the boy and the dragon become closer, so does the boy and everyone in the village, as he starts to dominate the dragons in the arena by, you know, loving them and understanding them. But everyone just thinks that Hiccup is this super Viking warrior now. When his dad returns to the village and learns that his son is no longer the laughingstock, he now feels proud and he's excited to spend time with his son. To finally gossip about dragon killing. So Hiccup wins the approval of everyone, even his father, and he scores himself a girlfriend too while he's at it. And he gets to ride a dragon. There's nowhere to go but down. I sure do hope nothing bad happens. Oh, Hiccup loses his reputation, his father loses a son, and Hiccup loses his dragon. Literally, they're all gone, left to go take out the dragon's nest. At least he still has a girlfriend. The last act of the movie isn't quite as strongly written as the rest of it, but it's certainly good enough. And it all makes sense and it comes together, it's just, you know, you gotta have the big exciting finale, and they do what they need to do to make that happen. The ending battle is actually pretty epic, with everyone coming together to fight the big bad. And the fight itself is really cool. With the emergence of this alpha dragon, you have all this debris flying everywhere, and the scale is huge, and it's pretty awesome. Everyone uses teamwork and strategy, and yeah, it's a fun time. I would even go as far as to say that the climax is rather breathtaking. And it results in an explosive finale. Hiccup survives, but he loses half his leg. It's actually a really poetic cost, since both Toothless and Hiccup have lost their mobility, but together they're able to fly. I think it's really neat. Leave me alone. The movie is bookended by narration from Hiccup, describing life on Berk in a humorous and informative way. And both the opening and the ending are just terrific. When How to Train Your Dragon first came out, I was very dismissive of it. I skipped out on going to a 3D showing of it because I thought it looked like some gimmicky, soulless kids movie. Just another one of the countless 3D movies that were trending at the time. And I couldn't have been more wrong. It's one of the very best animated films from DreamWorks. I think it's totally fantastic. A wonderful, heartfelt, and positive experience. Watching How to Train Your Dragon will not only make you a happier person, but it'll make you a better person. Maybe I'm overselling it, but seriously, it's great.